Blackstone presents Forge Master, a Lit RPG adventure by Seth Ring. This book is read by Eric Jason Martin. Prologue. The soft shuffle of feet on the smooth wooden floor was the only sound in the early morning darkness. Though the sun hadn't yet risen, the servants had, each moving as quickly as they could without running, heads down as they worked to ensure their master's absolute convenience during the coming day. Only one of them showed any expression, and it was a worried one. Impeccably dressed with hair streaked gray from stress, the middle-aged man chewed on his lip as he dragged his feet. He knew he shouldn't be delaying, but what was even more important was that he found the right words before he arrived at his destination. His quiet steps carried him through the twisting corridors of the castle until he came to a large doorway with two heavy-set guards. Completely covered in metal, the only part of them he could see was their fierce eyes, but he hardly registered their existence. Instead, when they caught sight of him, they hurried to open the door, allowing him entry into a waiting room. Rich red curtains that fell like waterfalls from the ceiling and gleaming gold decorations gave the room a sense of grandeur, and the chaise lounge in the middle of the room added a languid air. But the middle-aged man knew better than anyone just how deceiving the appearance was. Smoothing his hair with a trembling hand, he heard a sound from the other end of the room and hurried to bow his head as a beautiful woman who appeared to be in her 30s walked into the room, attended by three maids. Nodding to him, she sat down on the chaise and leaned back as the maids arranged her long flowing dress. Settling herself comfortably, she waved her hand for him to begin speaking.
Your Highness, we have failed to reestablish contact with the lower world you're interested in.
What do you mean, you failed to reestablish contact? Elmvina Tardoff Eisenstadt's eyes narrowed slightly, her attention settling on the clearly nervous servant.
You
know exactly how much I dislike people who waste my time, don't you? You would do well to bear in mind the fate of your predecessor, and you may be sure that this will be the only warning you will get. Quickly getting himself under control, the middle-aged servant bowed even deeper.
Yes, Your Highness. We have been trying for 2 days to reestablish our connection with the spirit dolls left behind, but the complete lack of reaction suggests they were all destroyed.
All of them? Elmvina asked, her forehead furrowing. Even the hidden ones?
Yes, Your Highness. We then tried to send another spirit doll down, but the transmission was rejected by the world spirit.
But it's a lower world. It doesn't have a world spirit.
That's why we were confused. But after numerous attempts, we can only conclude that a world spirit was born there recently. Naturally.
Letting out a low whistle, Elmvina sat up slowly, her expression changing to one of wonder, tinged with a hint of greed.
That means there's a true ruler there.
Are we the only ones being restricted?
No, Your Highness. All access has been cut off, at least to our knowledge.
I see. That's fine. Do your best to prevent this information from getting out, Elmvina said, waving her hand. With no one coming in or out, we have time to build up our strength.
Before she had finished speaking, she noticed the strange expression on the middle-aged servant's face. Trailing off, she raised one eyebrow.
What?
Your Highness, we've detected a major dimensional breach leaving that world. It was originally heading for our world, but diverted at the last moment, and we lost track of it. We know that it landed on one of the nearby worlds, but not which one.
Hold on, Elmvina said, resting her head in her hand as if she was suffering from a headache. You're telling me that after the lower world was sealed, someone still ascended? Isn't that impossible? True rulers completely prevent entry or exit from a world, so how is that possible?
We do not know, Your Highness. Furthermore, it looks like the breach was larger than average.
As soon as the middle-aged servant said the word larger, an image flashed into Elmvina's mind, causing her...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.